What's going on, guys? It's Curtis Sams here, back in a brand new video on this channel, where tomorrow morning we're going to be travelling to Oxford United for a Swansea City away game. It's a new ground ticked off for me, which I can't wait for, but in general, being a Swans fan, absolutely painful at the minute. No goals scored in October, and hopefully we get a goal tomorrow now. Obviously, it's Friday night, I'm staying in a hotel in Bridgend currently, and I hope that tomorrow we can get a goal scored. And we're currently winless in six. Like, it can't go on like this, can it? I mean, if we score tomorrow, I'll probably pull a hamstring, for most of you. But I hope not, because I'm a footballer myself and I don't want to injure myself just to try not to ruin my career. But I'm looking forward to the trip in general. But the 90 minutes, not too sure about, to be honest with you. But Oxford United are unbeaten at home this season, which worries me. And also, our record against Oxford United has not been good at all either. We got knocked out by them in the FA Cup in 2016. We lost 3-2, Kemal Roof destroying us by scoring a brace. And also in the Carabao Cup as well, 2 years ago, we were 2-0 up and then bottled a 2-0 lead to draw 2-2, a free kick scored, and we lost on penalties. And hopefully we can revenge them. Morning, everyone. It's match day, Saturday morning. It's the multiple time of 5-6 in the morning. But anyway, as I was saying last night, our record at Oxford United isn't really good at all. And our away record isn't even good either, because we've only scored 2 goals away from home this season. We've had 1 win, 1 draw, and the rest of them being losses. Well, obviously, the win was the last away game we were at, actually, which was Coventry City, where we were 2-1 winners. The draw was at Sheffield Wednesday, where it was 0-0 during our miserable October. So, yeah, I'm pretty sure you know, or seen on my YouTube shorts and my TikTok, that I couldn't make the game due to other commitments last Saturday, which was the Millwall home game. But apparently we played all right, apart from scoring a goal, standard. But then Millwall, Bob's your uncle, had their main chance and he scored from it. This is what happens when you don't take a chance, you see. I mean, it wasn't all bad, apparently, but the fact that we were winless in six and we not scored in October puts me at my wit's end, to be honest with you, and it does put Luke Williams under more pressure. I still think Luke Williams is the right man. We just need a big performance today. Oxford United are unbeaten at home. As I said, it's just not going to be easy today. But look at our next 3 games. Watford home, Burnley away, Leeds home. We need to get something today. Otherwise, we're going to be in big trouble, I'm afraid. But we've got Cyrus Christie back. Cyrus Christie was on loan with us at the end of 2021-22 season, which was the first season of Russell Martin. And he's back in a Swansea City shirt, which I can't wait for. But yeah, the bus leaves at 7 in the morning. I'm going to get changed and then we're going to head over there. See you guys in Oxford. Come on, Swans. So before we head to Kasam State, we've got our stop, which is Aberdeen United Clubhouse, for a pint and a bacon roll. It's a 12:30 kickoff, of course, and it's the multiple time of 10 o'clock. We're going to have a quick pint, bacon roll, and we'll be at the Kasam Stadium, so I'll see you guys there. Okay, so we've just seen the team now, just before we head to Kasam Stadium. In goal, we've got Lawrence Vigouroux, right back Josh Key, left back Josh Tymon, centre back Harry Darlan and Ben Cabango. Joe Allen comes in the team, we've got Gonçalo Franco and Matt Grimes in the field, so we've got a flat three. We've got Miles Parr-Harris on one wing, Rolls on the other wing, and Xander Potnik leading the line. Cyrus Christie is on the bench as well, hopefully we see him back in action, and also Aymar Govey is back on the bench as well, so hopefully we see him in action as well. So yeah, decent looking team, not gonna lie, but as I was saying, it will not be an easy game at all today. And I think if we fail to win or lose, well, especially if we lose, I think we'll be in trouble, unfortunately, unless there's a miracle from the January transfer window. Like, after the Leeds game, this is where we need to start picking up the wins and that. But yeah, I think we'll be in trouble if we don't win today. So yeah, I'll see you guys at Kasam Stadium. And hopefully it is 3 points instead of 0. I mean, a draw is better than nothing, I suppose, but 3 points, please.
And I just can't seem to get enough love. Swansea City.
Oh, Smith!
Lad, we're away. Let's see how the first half goes, shall we? Come on, Swans.
Come on, get in the box.
Hit it! Yes!
Oh!
Unlucky!
Come on.
Quick!
Yes! Oh, it's in the ball! Oh, man, it's Paul Harris off the ball. Oh, so close. Come on, lads, keep going!
Come on! Come on! We scored a goal! We actually scored a freaking goal! Oh, my God! Oh, my God, we scored! Oh!
Can you believe it? Swansea City have scored a goal! This is not a drill! Stanford Potnick drills it into the back of the net! Royal Typhoon in the cross! Oh, my God, we scored a goal! We scored a goal! We scored a goal! We scored a goal! It's only our third away goal of the season! And Stanford Potnick has got it! His second goal of the season! My God, we actually scored! And I didn't pull a hamstring either! Oh, my God! We scored a goal! We scored a goal! We scored a goal! Come on!
Making all the noise everywhere we go! Everywhere we go! Everywhere we go!
Oh, don't even think about it right at half time.
Oh!
Oh! Yeah, 3 minutes added on. Oxford hit the crossbar then, nearly an equaliser for them. So, half time, the Kassam Stadium, Oxford United 0, Swansea City 1, Xander Potnick getting a goal, which I can't believe I witnessed. We actually scored a goal. I honestly can't believe it. It feels like a dream. I pinched myself, and it's true. We scored a goal. And Xander Potnick getting his second of the season. Obviously, he scored his first goal against Preston North End in the first home league game of the season. And now he's got his second of the season. We've played pretty well so far, I've got to say. But Oxford United, they never give up these days. That's one thing you've got to be careful of. The second half, we need to turn up. And hopefully, we can hold on to this win. If we hold on, it'll be a huge result for us. And considering Oxford at home, they're unbeaten in a minute. Hopefully, it'll be the end. But I don't want to speak too soon, no, because you know what, like, they won against West Brom in their last home game and they brought it back to 1-1. A draw I wouldn't mind, but a win would be even better. But hopefully we can hold on to these 3 points. Come on, Swans.
Right, second half now needs to be solid again, lads. Otherwise we're in trouble.
Come on, let's make it two. Here's the cross.
What time it hits it, you got?
One.
In the box, darling. Yes!
Oh!
Almost 2-0, come on!
Whoa!
Oh, counter attack. Hey! Excellent stuff.
Oh,
we actually need.
Florian Piacini, his first goal of the season. Rob his first half.
You drop bastard. What a face on Florian Piacini. Make it 2-0 10 minutes ago. Fingers crossed. Pass enough now. Come on.
Couple of changes. Cyrus Christie is set to come on for his debut, for his second debut even for the club. Azim Abdullahi come alongside him. Obviously, the other substitutions, Bianchini, the second goal scorer, came on for Joe Allen. And we also brought on Liam Cullen as well for Vipotnik. That's our third window probably. But anyway, as we speak, we're mocking his Oxford fans. Cheerio! 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 Yeah, they are the Oxford fans. leaving in the car park with 8 minutes to go. Yeah, Cyrus Christie, the man of the moment, coming on once again on his one shirt. Oh, please see out of the window.
Good finish.
Good finish, to be fair, but don't do this now, Swans. Goodness sake. Oh. So there we are, guys. It is finished at Kasam Stadium. Oxford United 1, Swansea City 2. What a result. We needed that one big time. And it was Oxford United's first league home defeat of the season. And guess who's the first team to beat Oxford United at Kasam Stadium on their own turf this season? No other than Swansea, of course. We love breaking records, don't we? Considering we ended Millwall's poor away record, we ended Oxford United's good home record. Makes a change, doesn't it? I mean, it's down to Swansea City, isn't it? But yeah, the party bus on the way back to Bridgend is going on as we speak, and rightly so as well. What a result, what a win. I was very scared then when Dane Scarlett put one back for Oxford United, and they nearly made 2-2 as well. A header which they had, which was narrowly wide. But Xander Potten again his second of the season, which I'm happy for him for, and also I'm happy for Florian Bianchini as well, getting his first goal in a Swansea City shirt. And it was a lovely finish from him as well. Gonçalo Franco, what a pass from him as well, gotta say. Yeah, excellent results, which we needed. Watford home on Tuesday night now. Hopefully we can get another good result. Performance was really good as well, and I can't fault it, gotta say. And funny enough, I've been to both away games where we scored in this season, so I feel like I need to start going to away games more often. But yeah, really happy. Now hopefully we can build on for that now. Hopefully, I would love it if we shock Burnley and Leeds as well during our next three games. Obviously Watford home, then Burnley away, then Leeds home. It'd be nice if we shock them two. Well, two or three of them. Watford, I think we might have a slight chance against, but yeah, hopefully we can get the right results in the next few games now. If you want to see more content, make sure you like, subscribe, turn notifications, check out all my socials in the link below, as well as the World of Football podcast. And yeah, peace.